हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल इंटरफेस ए फोन कीपैड विद द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड विल सी दैट आवर आउटपुट विल बी लाइक दिस। इफ यू प्रेस 5 इट विल बी डिस्प्लेस्ड एज 5, इफ यू प्रेस 1 इट विल बी 1। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस प्रोजेक्ट। फर्स्टली वी विल गो टू द our microvision software. Here we will write the code. I will share this code in the description also. And firstly I want to show the circuit of the keypad. Here you can see that a phone keypad like this, there are the 4 rows and 3 columns, like we can see here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 star 0 and hash. So our aim is to print these things. So if we press 1, it will be displayed on the our display that 1 is pressed, and if we press 6, it will be 6. So as in this project, if we press 8, it will be 8. So let's start. What to do for this? We will go to the MicroVision software. As I already told in previous videos, that we will take a new file and we'll write this code. In this we are taking port 1 P1, you can see here, and assign 0 to 6 bits to different variables. Like in we can see here A, B, C, D, these are the rows, and 1, 2, 3 are the column. So we take this A, B, C, D in small here, and 1, 2, 3 as D0, D1, D2. After that, we define one function segment and go to the main program. Here we assign A, B, C, D as high. In last video, I told you that there are two type of inputs, high and low. For high we have to give the 1, and for low we have to give the 0 value. So here, after assigning all the A, B, C, D as high, we take A as 0 and check that D0 is 0, means is it there that 1 is pressed. If it's so, then our segment function will be called here and print the 0xf9. 0xf9 is for 1. 0xf9 is for 1 for the common anode type of LED, and its complement is for common cathode LED. I have posted one video regarding this also in 2-3 days ago, so you can see that also for the clarification. After that, again A is equal to B is equal to C is equal to D, all these inputs are again assigned high so that a new value can be pressed, and check that A is 0, and if D1 is 0, it will display as the 2, which is by this pin. And likewise, on going on this code, at the last we can take it as random that here we are assigning A, B, C, D as 1 and D is equal to 0, and if D1 is equal to 0, then print the 0x90, which is the code for the 0, which is for this. Let's start this. And I think I have written here for 0, for 9. So we will correct it and put here the value of the 0. We will rectify it. I think that is A4. We will correct it A4. Or A4, I think 0 0 3. one, two. Okay, let's check in the previous. Which I have already supplied. Let's check it. Array table. From the array table we can check that for 0 we have to take 0xC0. So we will change it 0xC0 and save it, rebuild it, and go to the our Proteus software. Here we will stop this program and again give the path of the our hex file, and now start it, and now press the 0, it is showing 0 949848. Okay, so this array table is very important, as I already told in previous video. So this table should be remembered to you, or you can generate these values by putting this matrix. So let's start again. So we were discussing that how to write the program. Here we write the program, and these segment values are the same as we want to print on pressing some particular bit. So after that we will go to the Proteus. Here we will take a new file. We will take these three components. Well, these two components are familiar with you. One is the 89C51 microcontroller, and one is the common anode type LED. This third one is new to you, which is the keypad for the phone. So you will put it here, make the connections like shown in this figure. We take first 4 bit of this port 0, 1, 2, 3 and connect it to the corresponding A, B, C, D, and take these 3, 1, 2, 3 to the 4, 5 and 6 of the port 1. Likewise, here we connect port 2, 0 to 6 pins to the common anode type of display. Here remember to give the power by using these terminals. In this terminal you will find this power, and you have to put it here. This program is running, so it is not possible. Now we will try again. Now we can put it. So this power is the same as shown here. So remember to connect this power, and after this you will go to this edit component. Here you will set this frequency 11.0592 and will give the path of your hex file and connect it keyboard hex, and it will be the output. So I just want to revise how to build the hex file. Here you will go to the target, and at the target on clicking right click, it will give the options for the target one. You will click it and set the frequency as 11.0592, and here in the output you will click this point, create hex file. In this way you can create the hex file. On this, you after that you have to save it and build or rebuild accordingly. And here if the errors are 0 and the warnings are 0, your program is okay. You can debug it by pressing start stop debug session. And if you want to check the outputs, then it can be checked on the ports which you have taken for the output. Here we have taken the port 2. So we can see the values of port 2. We also use the port 1, so we can also check the values of the port 1 bits. And these are the for the debugging for step by step process. So as you press it, these values of port 1 and port 2 will change accordingly as per the input. As I said that port 2 will be given on after pressing only. That's why here port 2 values are not changing, because port 2 is the output which can be displayed after the pressing the key only. So in this way you can interface any keypad of the phone by making these connections, and after running, so here we can see if we press 8, output is 8, 6, 6, 2, 1, 4, 7, 3, 9 and 0. This is our main aim of this project. So I hope all you will do at your home. I will provide the code in the description as well as the procedure to do this project. Thank you very much for watching this video. Okay, thank you.